Hello everybody and welcome to the second lab exercise that we have for Bio 110. First and foremost, how are y'all guys doing? I hope you're all doing great. I hope that you're all alive and that you're not sick, because right now I think that is like what everybody's really worried about. We don't want anybody getting sick, so I hope you're all doing fine. Anyway, our topic for today is really pretty interesting. It's still about ecology, of course. Now we're going to look at one of the main transactions that's taking place all over the world with every breath we take, and that would be, of course, photosynthesis and respiration. So let's get cracking. We're just going to divide this into very basic parts. First, we want to talk about energy as the currency of life. Then we're going to look into the world's energy makers and users. And then, of course, so what, man? Why do I care about this shit? Yes, of course. There's always that part where we have to reflect about how this is important to us and to everything else around us. And finally, moving forward, how you're going to proceed with your experiments. Okay. As living things, all living things, whether you are a teeny tiny bacteria or whether you are a little plant or whether you are a human being, there is a common denominator of the things that you need. And what is that? E1. But no, E1 stands for four things. E for energy, W for water, A for air or an atmosphere, and N for nutrients. Ganun lang ka simple. Four basic things that all life on earth needs. And particularly for this discussion, we are concerned with energy. So saan ba nanggagaling yung energy dito sa earth? It comes from the sun. Yes, that's the wonderful thing, is that the sun, the center of the solar system, is what really powers life on earth. But even though the sun is this massive ball of energy, how does it get to us? How do we actually utilize it? That's why we have a very important piece of the equation, is that we need organisms that can actually harness the power of the sun. And these are what we call producers. So sabi nga natin sa physics, energy cannot be created nor destroyed. So the energy from the sun is really just being cycled around the planet. And that's all thanks to the producers. And they do that through this process called photosynthesis. There is also another way to produce energy through chemosynthesis, and that does not require sunlight, but we're not going to talk about that now. For now, we're just going to be concerned with photosynthesis, because that is really the main driver or the main harvester of the sun's energy there. And quite simply, the chemical reaction is right below. Yan nga po. Carbon dioxide and water, together with the power of the sunlight, can produce simple sugars and oxygen. So yan po yung ginagawa ng ating mga halaman. And apart from that, not only vascular plants, but basically just anything that has chloroplasts. So for example, phytoplankton. So there are single-celled organisms floating around in the ocean that are too small to be seen by the naked eye, but still they can actually produce a lot of oxygen. In fact, more than rainforests, phytoplankton, our oceans, these organisms in the oceans, they produce a significant amount of oxygen for our atmosphere, and they also suck up carbon, a lot of carbon in puyon. And of course, if there are producers, the ones that produce energy for us, then there are consumers, the ones that actually use the energy. So kasama tayo dun sa grupo na yon. We do this through the process of respiration. Respiration, as a chemical equation, is simply the reverse of photosynthesis. Isn't it beautiful? So all you have to do is take photosynthesis and shove it in front of a mirror and you get respiration. But yeah, something like that. Kumbaga, yan lang po yun. Kung ano yung pinoproduce ng halaman, ginagamit natin. Kung ano yung pinoproduce natin, ginagamit ng halaman. So it's a closed loop. That's the beautiful thing, right? Walang sayang, walang labis, walang kulang. And that is how we are able to sort of honor the law of thermodynamics. Energy cannot be created nor destroyed. Umiikot-ikot lang din yan sa earth. Yan po yun. And that is through photosynthesis and respiration. Ayan. Now, ayan naman kung ganon. What exactly does this have to do with us? What exactly is the significance of photosynthesis and respiration? First and foremost, let's look at biodiversity. In fact, the significance of biodiversity. As human beings, I think this is an ego check. For most of us, we always kind of think that we are the center of this whole planet. We are the most important creatures in this planet. But is that really the case? When in fact, can we even survive without plants? Can we survive without oxygen? Eh, saan ba nanggagaling yung oxygen? Kundi dahil din sa mga halaman na nagpo-produce ng oxygen. Can we survive without the sun? Diba? Kasi doon nanggagaling yung energy natin. And so, ngayon, kailangan natin ng middleman, yung kayang gamitin yung energy ng sun. Diba? Eh kasi tayo, kahit naman mag-sunbathing ka dyan sa labas buong araw, diba? There's no way you're gonna get the energy from the sun. All you're really gonna get is a massive sunburn. And that's it. And skin cancer. If you try to do that all the time. But yeah, yun lang mapapala mo. You're never gonna be able to create energy from just lying, you know, outside. Nope, that's not gonna happen. You're gonna need plants. And so I think that's the importance. So yun nga po yung sinasabi natin na keystone species. Sino ba talaga yung importante sa mundo? Tao ba? Paisip kayo dyan, di ba? O yan. And next, of course, a very important issue. I think this is the issue that the younger generation will face. I'm very sorry, ito na po yung magiging problema ng panahon po ninyo. And that is the climate crisis. The main question is, what is happening with photosynthesis and respiration if we look at the climate crisis? Are we respiring more? Kasi di ba yun yung nangyari? There's an increase in CO2 emissions in our atmosphere. Yun po yung the main concern is that we need to lower our carbon dioxide emissions by the year 2050. Yung mga ganyang kemerot. So, yun yung ibig sabihin nun. That means that we're really pumping more carbon dioxide than the producers can absorb back through photosynthesis. And that is exacerbated by the fact that we are actually sort of just destroying habitats. In other words, deforestation, and we're pretty much killing our oceans. So that means the mechanisms that are supposed to absorb carbon dioxide, unti-unting nawawala. Kasi pinapatay natin yung mga halaman. Diba? Di wala nang mag-absorb ng carbon dioxide. Nang gagawin natin? Yun po yun. Kaya ito po yung isa sa mga hinaharap natin ngayon. It's a climate crisis. And finally, from a more like introspective, reflective kind of thing, we realize that photosynthesis and respiration, I love the Tai Chi too. It's the symbol of nature. It's just this very wonderful, simple symbol of nature. And that is balance. Photosynthesis and respiration, kind of like life and death, diba? And a lot of other things, black and white, light and shadow, empty and full, they're two sides of the same coin. And one cannot exist without the other. Ganun lang siya. And in our lives, I think that's what we need to be reminded of, that life is about balance. If we can't always be happy, sometimes we need to be sad. Because how will we really know if we're happy if we don't experience sadness? Kumbaga, yun yung nagiging gauge mo kung happy ka, diba? Kasi alam mo kung ano yung, you know how it feels to be sad, and so you know how it feels to be happy. And you know that these things don't last. In the same way that you know that photosynthesis will occur, and you know that respiration will occur at the same time. Diba? In opposite. So, cherish that moment that you have that you're happy, because you know that eventually you might be sad. But then also when you're sad, know that it's not gonna last forever. You're gonna be happy again. Paulit-ulit lang yan. Paikot-ikot lang yan. So, yun yung mga hugot na pwede nating makuha mula sa mga halaman. Ayan po. Diba? Now, moving forward. Diba? Ang dami ko na sinabi. How do we go about with your experiments? So, you will notice that for this lab activity, you have two main outputs. The individual output is pretty easy, pretty straightforward. So, kayang-kaya nyo na yan. But for the group activity, so yun yung medyo, kailangan nyo lang ng recap of basic chemistry, particularly your acid-base indicators. Naalala nyo yung mga pH paper na nagbabago yung kulay kapag nilublog mo sa acidic or sa basic solutions? That's basically what the experiment is about. You have this solution that will sort of change color depending on how acidic or how basic the water is. So the main question is, what is happening to the water? If you know what is happening to the water on a chemical level, then you should be able to answer the questions in your worksheet. Easy peasy, okay? Yun lang po yun. And yeah, I hope nakatulong tong pre-lab na to. Ang dami ko nasabi, pero yun, sana mag-enjoy din kasi experiments ninyo. Don't forget, always just to keep in constant communication with your groupmates. And yes, thank you so much. If you have any other questions, leave a message in Canvas or you can course them through your blockmates. Just find ways to reach out online na, guys. So there's just so many ways to, you know, sort of connect. Okay, so yun lang po. That's it, pansit. Kita-kits ulit sa susunod na lab exercise. Bye, guys!